Bosnia. My name is Mersiha and I'm doing Bosnian cooking lessons in my home. This is my kitchen and usually this is the place where miracle happens. So for 1 year and a half we are having guests from all over the world. And for now, we had 30 countries here, and definitely people from all over the world are interested into Bosnian cuisine. Today, we will prepare some of the dishes which are known in whole Balkans and basically in whole region. Burek and stuffed onions, stuffed peppers and japraks, which maybe some of you tried in Greece or Turkey, but burek, definitely not. That's like proper Bosnian meal. So we have green leaves, japrak, that's called sarma, with fresh cabbage or pickled cabbage. But today we will make with green leaves, mangold leaves. So I'm using frozen ones. Why? Because for preparing this meal, usually you need to boil the leaves. No matter what kind, are those mangold leaves or Swiss chard or wine leaves, cabbage leaves, kale, whatever. You need to boil it for 5 to 10 minutes. But this is a really nice example how to save a lot of vitamins and to save your time. I just take them from my freezer and put them in warm water. And you just let them stand for a minute or two and they are ready. And in meantime, we will prepare onion for stuffing. So usually when you're taking your onion, you are trying to save as much as you can, but not right now. So we are cutting a little bit wider. So like this, so you have really nice surface and it's wide. Why? Because later on we need to take these inner layers out after boiling. So we will boil them let's say approximately 5 to 10 minutes, and it all depends from size of the onion, is it really fresh or not. So we will take these little two. They are ready. Put them in the water and let it boil 5 to 10 minutes. We will prepare our mixture for stuffing. So we will use beef, but of course you can use chicken meat or whatever you prefer. Usually we get that kind of questions. Can we use some other meat or can we like vegetarian option? Of course, yes, you can. So I just peel one onion. It's much easier to grind. You don't cry a lot, so let's say like standard things. This is pepper, this is vegetta, which is basically heritage from ex-Yugoslavia. It's produced in Croatia. So now I'm gonna wash the rice. I will take half of the cup. And this is short grain rice. Why am I using short grain rice? Because later on it's when you cut japrak or the stuffed onion, it's very easy to cut it because everything sticks together. Why? Because of the rice, of course, because it acts like a glue. And if you are using long grain rice, everything falls apart. So definitely use short grain rice. So we will add it here. So no need to boil the rice or anything else. It's just washed rice. One pepper. So we have basically a lot of vegetables and fruits and pies and yeah, a lot of things. Cut it and wash the seeds out. I will use half for the sauce and half to put here in the meat. There are a lot of flavors. Okay, so I will add a little bit of oil. You can use olive oil if you want, but we are using this sunflower. A little bit of sweet paprika. You can use chili, you can use smoked paprika if you like, so it's all up to you and your preferences. A little bit of pepper. And of course, vegeta. So now mixing everything together. What's really good about the food that we are making today is that you can save it in your freezer, in your freezer after baking, and also you can keep it in your fridge for 2 or 3 days, and you just take one day and you prepare a bunch of it and then you are safe for days. So basically, how to know when they are ready? Soon these middles are gonna pop out, and when you press the onion like this, it will basically act like it's moving or it's breathing. So that's how you know it's ready. So a couple of minutes more and it's ready. We prepared our mixture and I will show you how to make japrak. So first of all, we need to get rid of this thicker part, because it's very hard to roll japrak with that. And of course, you can use that later on for the sauce. So now we are having this leaf with a hole. So you just cover one side with another. You just take a little bit of meat of this mixture, cover one side, and then you are rolling all the way to the end and then closing one side. And if you're having this situation, you just get rid of meat and then close. This is your japrak. Continue with others. And basically repeating the process. You can of course make smaller ones, bigger ones, it is all up to your preferences. But in Bosnia, in old days, when my mom was a little child, when her mom was teaching her how to do this, she was basically saying the smaller the better. Why? Because That way you are showing your skills, because it's very easy to make big ones, but it's very hard to make really small ones as your pinky finger. And usually they would just cut the leaf, let's say, in two halves. You see how it's really tiny, really small? So they would take like this, take really small piece of meat, and they would roll it like this. You see the difference? So you see how it pops out? That means they're ready. Take the onions out, and I will save this onion water for later because it's really healthy. So I will just put it in the sauce, like, just to cool them down a little bit. So you are pressing from one side to another. And trying to take these inner layers out. These smaller ones you just press and they will pop out. So you take your onion like this. So filling just near the edge, because rice definitely needs some space for later on to rise. That's good. So this is also from our freezer. And this is called potato pepper. Why? Because it looks a little bit like a potato, and they are amazing for stuffing and for pickling, so whatever your preferences are, you can just use it for a lot of different things. So just clean the seeds out and they are ready. So similar thing as for tomatoes, you just take the middle, the seeds and the meat, and you left everything around. Now we can just make a little bit of more green leaves. And also, if you would like to make vegetarian option, sometimes during the summer we are not so much into meat, so we would like some easier things to have. So you can definitely, instead of meat, use rice, this short grain, and also different kinds of vegetables. You can just chop tomato, different colors of peppers, you can add and grind carrots and zucchinis and fry all together. Add a little bit of water so the rice can rise, and later on rice will act like a meat. So you have your vegetarian option, and you can stuff these the same things basically with that vegetarian option. And that vegetarian option is called yalan dolma. And yalan dolma is basically Turkish words. Those are Turkish words.
and basically that means fake dolma.
Now we will prepare our sauce. So in Bosnia, we learn throughout the war time, unfortunately, how to take care of food, because at that time we didn't have much, so we appreciated every piece that we had. So we are doing that also even today. So we are using these leftovers, let's say like that. So boiled onions, these really small ones, so we will chop them. And also these thicker parts of mango leaves. A little bit of sweet paprika. And we will add different seasonings later on. A bunch of tomatoes during the summer, so we are definitely keeping everything for the winter. And it's ready for chopping. So now you just chop your frozen tomato. So I'm using these for different sauces, for pasta, for pizza, for everything basically that I can. Because it's really nice when you have your own without any pesticides or anything. So it's much better than buying tomato paste for the thickness of the sauce. Add a little bit of vegetta. So maybe you notice that when I'm using vegetta, I don't use any salt because there is already salt in there. Pepper, a little bit of celery. And now we'll add onion water. Have our pepper and onions. So now we will put everything in the oven for approximately 35 to 40 minutes. We need to turn our oven on, so 250 for 30 to 40 minutes. So first down and later on in the middle, so it gets really nice color on top. So this is my hometown, Sarajevo, and to be honest, it was really tough and hard during the siege of Sarajevo. Of course, at that time we were surrounded all up on the hills. We had soldiers and we couldn't get any food in Sarajevo at that time. So today we are taking for granted many things regarding the food and everything else. But regarding the food, it was very difficult at that time. And just for example, when our guests are asking us, you know, how it was and what did we eat during the wartime, definitely we always think about the onion. Why onion? Because that is one of the examples how it was very tough at those times, because when you smell the onion in the street, that was like something the best that can ever happen to you. Why? Because we didn't have any onions during the wartime. And that shows you basically how tough it was, because we didn't have any food and onion was like very best gift that you can get during the war. Food at that time was pretty basic, like something that we would plant in our gardens, you know, to grow it during that time. And even that was very difficult. Why? Because we didn't have any water, so we would collect the water or rain when it falls, so we would water with that water all those plants. And definitely we would get some humanitarian aid at that time, but that wasn't really enough. So we really, even today, we are trying to appreciate everything that we have. I will show you now how to prepare filo dough for burek. And we need 2 scoops of just regular flour, so no yeast, no baking soda, nothing. A little bit of salt. And a little bit of oil. Just a little bit. And we need warm water. So now we will just mix it all together. I'm just slightly adding water. Why? Because if you add too much, it's gonna be really watery. And if you don't add enough, otherwise it's gonna be really hard. And later on, we can't stretch it. So it's much better when you're doing it slowly. When my mom was teaching me how to do this, I always asked her, how do you know how soft it has to be? And she was always telling me, just touch this part of your ear and you will know. And I was, oh my God, always trying and mixing, and I didn't know what she's talking about. But definitely, when you're practicing a lot, you know what she's talking about. Flour onto the flour. So now we are going from the outside to the inside, just slightly pressing. It's like you're closing something in the center until it's not sticky anymore. Just put the oil below to cover the surface. And we put our little dough and just slightly press. And then cover with the oil on top so it gets the oil everywhere, like a oily massage. And now we will let it rest for 15 minutes. Of course, it has to be closed. And after 15 minutes, it's ready to stretch it. So we already prepared one dough. So it was standing for 15 minutes. And it's ready to continue with our process of stretching and preparing our filo. It's very soft right now and very flexible. So it's all because it had enough time to
to stand. So now we are repeating process, covering our dough with the flour, and now it's not sticky anymore, but it's oily a little bit, and we need to cover it with the flour and stretch it even more. We are stretching from one side to another, and also using different techniques basically, but at the beginning it's just simple moves like this, and always try to be careful at this point. Why? Because it can become really sticky and stick onto the rolling pin or onto the sheet. So just adding flour from time to time to prevent that not to happen. Covering our rolling pin, trying to roll. Flip it over and unroll. And also we need more flour. So just basically repeating the process of stretching. And the most important thing is basically to stretch it to be as paper thin, and that makes the best burek ever. So you can go and use that technique, or another technique of stretching it with the help of gravity. So you just spread the flour around the kitchen and you just put it down, and basically oiling. And it may look to you like, oh my god, this is like too much oil, but this oil basically helps for this dough to stretch even more. Rub the oil in, and we will let it rest for 5 minutes on a room temperature. And it's much better if it's warmer than when it's colder. If it's colder, you can't stretch it properly, so make sure to have a warmer kitchen. So now we need our beef. Just fresh minced beef with grinded onion, which I will grind right now. A little bit of oil. Vegetta. And pepper. And our mixture for burek is ready. We will just check up our dough. Oh yeah, it's ready. So when you pull towards yourself and you feel no resistance, then you know it's ready. If you do feel something, so just let it stand for a couple of minutes more and that's it. So you don't leave how just a couple of minutes make such a difference. So just go around and try to stretch it even more. Even if it breaks, just forget about the holes, because when eating, you can't feel the holes. You just need to stretch it to be as paper thin. So forget about the holes and try, despite everything, to stretch it even more. So now we need to remove these thicker parts, and we're not gonna throw this away because this is our new burek later on. But definitely now we need to remove it because it's thicker than the rest of the phyllo dough, and we can just take it back in the oil, like this. And if we have some more, just add here, cover in the oil, and that's it. You can reuse it again later on. Now we will check our dolmas. Are they ready? Oh yes, they are. We need our mixture for burek. And we are putting in small pieces like this and trying to fill the gaps. So we do have meat everywhere. Our phyllo. It sticks a little bit onto the sheet, but it's okay. So for the beginners, I always suggest for them to roll with their hands like this. It's a lot easier than with the sheet. So you can do like that, or you can roll with the sheet like this, cut. So I'm separating this part from the rest of the phyllo, like this. Always taking these ends off because they are very thick and we don't need thicker dough. So now I'm gonna make four bureks. So twisting and pressing to take this part. Twist this side and then another one around. And here is your small burek. And they are ready. So now covering again.
just warm. And sometimes people are asking, how do you know how many times to roll this part with meat? Well, it all depends. Is your filo thin as paper or not? If it is, you can add more layers like I did just right now. If not, you can just add one or two and that's pretty much it. Baking paper. I will turn the oven on 250. And I'll take little bureks and put them here. Little bit of oil, and then you can control what you are doing.
Ready for the oven. So first we will put it down. So it gets really nice color below. And then we will put it in the middle so it gets really nice color on top, and that's it for approximately 40 minutes. And our burek is, I will just take a little bit of butter. We are done for today. We finished with our famous Bosnian traditional meals. Definitely, if you ever find yourself in Sarajevo, in Bosnia, I would like to invite you to visit us and try one of the most famous dishes in the region, which is burek, and also other local delicacies with the most beautiful view on Sarajevo, of course, in our home. And at the end, what else than to try